Hey guys, I'm here in northern Utah, in the Rocky Mountains. And what I want to talk about is emergency preparedness and having backup power to be able to stay warm. Because you can imagine here in the mountains, we're in early December and we don't have snow yet, but we've had snow and there will be a lot of snow over the course of the next few weeks. And so this could be a very treacherous area. And if you were to ever be stranded or stuck in an area like this, you'd want to be able to stay warm, especially if there's a power outage or just any way that you can prepare. And I'm going to show you another way right here. So as you've seen in my previous videos, I've actually talked a little bit about this mid-size power pack. This has about as much juice in it as a standard car battery. It's just under 90 amp hours. So it gives you the ability to carry portable power, to be able to power a blanket like this. And this blanket I picked up at Walmart for under 25 bucks. So it's not a bad blanket. Can you hold it out, Nora, so you can see how big it is? All right, so it's not a huge blanket, but it's perfect for a lap blanket. It's actually designed to go inside of a car, and you carry it in your car with you, and you plug it in the dashboard. And that's why this pack has a power port on it, just like your car does, so that you can basically take this anywhere. Now then, it doesn't have to be for emergencies only. Can you imagine yourself being at a football game? They always play football in the wintertime, and you're sitting at a football game watching your son or daughter or whoever it is playing sports. And you want to stay warm. This is perfect. You can carry this in, put the blanket on, and stay warm all evening while you're out watching your kids or grandkids have fun with their sports. So this is a great option for being able to have power just about anywhere you want. Do you have anything to say about that, Nora?
It warms up pretty quickly. I could actually already feel it warming up. It's really, really soft.
Soft and comfy?
Very soft and comfy.
There you have it, right from her. Soft and comfy and warm. So she's actually warm and I'm cold because it's in the 40s here. That's not freezing, but it's cold enough for me and I don't like it too cold. All right, with that, I will go into the details of this and we're going to keep this really brief. All right, guys. So what I want to show you is the inside of this pack. I'll walk through the details of it, but I'm going to do another video where I'm actually going to build a smaller pack. So you get to see the main concept, but it's going to be in a smaller case. I wanted something that was a little more portable than the big pack. So, and it's not as big as the one on wheels, but I'll have the different sizes. So let's just walk through this and then you can refer to the other pack, the small pack that I'm building. So basically what I have in here is 42 cells and they're in blocks of 8. So there's 8 cells here, 8 cells here, 8 cells here and 8 cells here. So that gives me a 42 cell pack, but I'm running 8P4S. So these are all in parallel, and then we run, so each one's in parallel, and then we run the whole thing in series. So you end up with basically a 16 volt case. Well, most of you are probably saying, well, yeah, but cars are 12 volt. Yeah, that's true. But if you look at the voltage range when a car is actually running, it's upwards of 15 volts. So it's not truly, you know, full 16. And like I've said earlier, when I was designing packs, I don't push my packs to their full limits. So this is drained a little bit. So you can see here when I turn the power on, it's running currently at 15. I've already got probably 3 hours of blanket use out of it, as you saw the blanket. So this actually lasts for quite a while. What I have in here and how I control my charging is this little charge unit here. This is a lithium ion charge controller, which does constant current, constant voltage, which allows me to adjust where the battery cutoff is because I don't want to fill these too full. So I use this here to actually step it down. Now how I do the charging is I found this charger, I found it at a thrift store. So you can, you know, look around for stuff like this because I picked this up for a buck. This is the charger for Philips, something Philips may have been a laptop or whatever. And this one here does an output of 16 volts, which if I didn't even control it, I could charge these batteries just with this unit. The problem is this would continue to push juice into the batteries when I need it to cut off, because you don't want to trickle charge lithium ions like you do a lead acid battery. So that's a little bit different. So you need to have some sort of charge controller, even though this is here. I picked this up for, I mean, literally a buck. This was a buck, and I had to buy another cord, you know, a regular PC cord, for a buck. Go to your thrift stores. They have stuff like this. And if it doesn't work, you know, you're out a buck. You're not out 20 bucks or 30 bucks. Okay, back in here. One of the things that I had a problem with is when I start charging, I don't want my batteries to keep my charge unit running all the time. I want it to be able to shut off. And so I'm using a 24 volt solenoid switch, and I've wired it in, and I'll put a wiring diagram of this pack on my website. You can go to the DIYengineer.com and you can look at the wiring diagram for this pack. And it allows me to start, you know, when I put my charging in, the charger will then run, but when I disconnect the charger, it turns off so that the batteries don't continue to run the charger. Wiring them directly, I ended up having backfeed, and it would actually keep this thing on and it would keep it running. So I needed a way to shut it off, and so I used this switch, this solenoid. All right, and then in here, all I've done is I've just wired in some components, some minor components. So I have this voltage meter, which gives me where I'm at in my pack, and then I have the 12 volt standard car outlet where I can plug in the blanket. And then I also have a couple USB ports. These are, I always put in the 2.1 amp. In the back here, I have an on-off switch that's lighted. And there's also a fuse unit here. So I mainly use this for the charging side of it, so that if something happens with the charger, it doesn't overload the batteries. It'll kill it right here at the fuse. And then this here is my charge port. So if I plug this in here, it initiates a charge. You can't really tell here, but if you look inside, let's see if I can turn it where you can see it. Yeah, you can see the little red light in here. That is the charge controller has kicked in, and it's now trickle charging, and you can see the voltage. So my voltage now is at 15.3, and that'll just keep crawling up until I get to 15.5, and it shuts off at 15.5. But that is the charge controller, and it's doing its job and putting juice back into the cells. All right, so with that, I just wanted to give you a quick update on this pack. I've shown you some my bigger packs, and I'm going to go ahead and build this out. I'm going to video building this into a pack. I'm not sure what size the cells are going to be yet, but I'm going to run this also in a four cell pack series. So it's going to be also 16 volts. Just won't have as much capacity as this pack or the portable power pack that I have that's much larger. All right, with that, I'm going to call this video over and we'll move on to the next project. And till then, we'll see ya. Okay, I hope the information I provided in this video was helpful. If you like what you saw, please subscribe below and please share with your friends and come back frequently. If you have any questions or comments about what you saw in this video, please leave them in the comments below and I'll gladly get back to you. Thanks for watching.